At this point, you have your new Xactimate X1 desktop app installed. You can navigate the Control Center, and you have set your preferences. You're ready to start working in Acclaim, but everything is set up a little differently than you're used to. Not to worry, we are here to help you navigate the new X1 desktop app. This is the fourth and final video focusing on the differences between Xactimate 28 and X1. Our goal is to prepare you to confidently and effectively use the new desktop version of Xactimate X1. Let's jump right in and get started with a new project. From the Local Projects tab, click New Project. Enter the claim name, select the profile, and click Create. You will see that the new X1 desktop retains the main functionality that you are used to, but with a new look. The biggest change between Xactimate X1 and 28 is that your navigation tools are now located on the user-friendly menu bar. Let's check it out. The arrow icon will collapse or expand your menu bar, giving you more room to work with in your project workspace. You can ensure that your project is being saved by turning on your autosave and checking for the green checkmark. Click the drop-down arrow to adjust your autosave settings. Your claim summary, grand totals, and coverage limits can be viewed on the menu bar rather than at the bottom of your project window. As we proceed, you will notice that your workspace windows appear as they did in Xactimate 28. Many items that were scattered throughout have now been streamlined with added performance. With the new X1 app, you will spend less time clicking on various tabs and icons, giving you more time to manage and complete projects. Let's get to work on our claim. Claim info is where you will find the windows for insured info, coverage and loss, and parameters. In the Parameters tab, you can download a current price list, request a supplemental price list, or a prior month's list. To set a price list, click on the drop-down list, and you will see price lists that you have previously downloaded. If you want to request a new price list, click on the Smart List option, then Request Price List, search by location or name, set your date and profile, and click Download. Once your price list has been successfully downloaded, highlight it and click Done. In the Estimate tab, you'll notice that sketch and estimate items are merged under a single tab as the Estimate Writer. Let's check out Sketch and the Editing toolbar. Here you will see Tools, Options, and Annotations in the menu bar, along with your editing tools. Under the Options tab, you can click the full screen icon to minimize and maximize your sketch window. Save View allows you to save 3D and elevation views to add to your reports. You can also set sketch preferences and inspect the level. If you like to use keyboard shortcuts, hover your mouse over an editing icon to see if one is available. The Estimate Items window has not changed. In the menu bar, you'll find Items, Components, Supporting Events, Labor Minimums, and Labor Summary tabs. Another difference to point out is the Photos tab. Previously, the Photos pop-up window was available from anywhere within an estimate. Now, the Photos tab is where you will go to upload, describe, and annotate images. Once you have your images uploaded in the Photos tab, you can easily place an image reference in your sketch workspace, just as you would have in Xactimate 28 by using the Images pane. The Print pop-up window is now called Reports and can be found in the Documents tab. Custom forms can be found here as well on the menu bar. The Documents tab is also where you will find Report Management and Loss Recap. The New Tools tab houses options that were scattered throughout Xactimate 28, and they can now be found in one accessible location. The Video Collaboration tab has replaced the video camera icon, which syncs up with claim experience. Vendor Exchange has replaced the V icon, the third-party access to vendors with integration to Xactimate. In Xactimate 28, the Underwriting Checklist and Payment Tracker were in the Complete tab. Those options can now be found here in Tools. You will also find the Copy from Project option and the Work Orders window under this tab. The Complete tab does just that. It completes your project. The Estimate Inspection will alert you to any required fields or inspection results that need to be addressed, or it will let you know that everything looks great. Once you click Mark Complete, you will be given the option to resequence line numbers. The project will then be sent to the cloud, and pricing info will be sent to Xactware's pricing team. If you need to make additional edits after a project has been marked complete, find and download the project from the cloud, open it, return to the Complete tab, and click Mark in Progress. Once you are done working in a project but not ready to mark it complete, click Save and Exit, and you will return to your local projects page. And that's it for the differences between Xactimate X1 and 28. If you have additional questions, please check out our e-service center. You can find the link below in the description. Fill out the survey below to let us know if there's anything you'd like to learn more about. And be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more expert tips each week.